you're going to reap it. You're going to reap it. Our families in America are so messed up because families don't believe the Bible anymore. God allowed this to, oh, it doesn't end right there, because you can go to chapter 19, verse 4. The king covered his face and cried out with a loud voice, "My son Absalom, oh Absalom, my son," he never got over that. And it started with that look at Bathsheba. That's where it starts, my friends. You young people better get me. It's starting in you at a young age. And the mess is there. And it never goes away. It never goes away. You need Jesus to put a cap on that. Because this is the results of it. Your entire family will be devastated. You can pray all day in the church. God won't hear you because your life is a mess. God only hears you when you're right. In conclusion, let me say this. Could David retreat to the past and change the future? No, he couldn't do it. He couldn't do it. David could not escape and say, "Well, now let me go back now." No, no, wait a minute. Tamar had been raped and ravished and messed up, and Amnon dead, and the other sons that was at the dinner all ran out because they thought they were next. They're all in rebellion, and Absalom, your favorite son, he's dead, and Solomon's going to get the kingdom, and he's a whoremonger extraordinaire. Have you ever thought about what this man's life, how it ended? Another question that we ask is that, didn't he understand that present actions determines future events? No. Oh, man, hey, God's going to work it out. No, he's not. You parents, listen to me. God works out nothing that you don't put your hand to work out down here. He has you here for that. I'm just going to pray. What you praying for? He doesn't hear you. Don't give in to your children's mess. Cut them off. "Mama, can I go somewhere?" You need to sit. "Girl, what do you want to go there for?" And then she bow her head and won't say nothing to you. "See, you get your behind in that bedroom. You ain't going nowhere." And then mama, if she leaves that bedroom and act like she want to run away from home, mama, you try to keep her there. But if she run away from home, give her that article that Sister Frost presented. Say, "Now, do you believe this? You going to run away from home? You going to be sleeping? What do you want out there?" You know what it is? It's that viper. It's that viper wanting to come out. Parents, you're obligated to say, as long as you're in this house, no, you're not. Over my dead body. And you better hope they ain't got no muscles, because they may try to do it over your dead body. Children, you listen to me. This is a true incident that happened to Amnon and Absalom, and it will happen to you. You listen to your headstrong friends out there. See, I know I'm telling you the truth. I used to be like that. Could he not have seen that God had purpose behind divine instruction? When God said the king of Israel should only have one wife and not, didn't he see that God had a purpose? Don't you people understand that God has a purpose for telling you what he's telling you in this book? This just isn't written as a story. There's a purpose behind this document. The document is given to protect you from this kind of tragedy. Was he so blind that he could not envision a defective family from his offspring being infected? See, he was infected, so he defected everybody around them. And when you're infected with some, and look, don't lie to me. I'm not going to lie to you. I know what my defect is. I was telling my daughter just the other day, I says, "Honey, you're somewhat like me. I'm real strong in that area, and you got to watch that." See, I'm real enough, Deacon Eddington, to tell my daughter the way I am and was. And then when I see some stuff in my offspring that is just like me, because that stuff is passed on, you better say, "Hey, look, you better get hold of this, because this mess will destroy you." But are you just, "Well, I'm just going to pray." You go, "What? I'm just going to pray and God's going to act." God's going to what? Tell them about you, silliness. "Oh, no, I'm holy. I'm straight. I'm well." No, you're ruined. You're defected and they've been infected. What is the lesson for the believer today as spoken in this lesson? I believe that the lesson is seen clearly in the house of Domino. That's it. That's your life. That's your life. It's all gonna fall over, friends. One swoop, one thing you don't deal with. Now you may say, oh no, I'm a Christian, that ain't, I'm gonna change. You can't change nothing. You better know that what happened to those dominoes is gonna happen to your house. It's gonna fall. I didn't make this up. I hope that you can re-listen again to this text of scripture. I didn't make this up. It's all in the Bible. That's why I said your text is from the Old Testament. I had to break it down to just let you know what happens in your house when you start losing control. You youngsters better know me. Just like those dominoes just fell, your life's going to collapse right in front of you. And whoever you pass that mess, when you have children, they come up, they're going to be just like you. And then you're going to bring them to me, and I'm going to say, how have you lived? What are you listening to? How do you talk? What is your lifestyle all about? Do you compromise? Are you for real? Are you a joke? Are you willing to take your youngsters and say, look, mama wasn't too tied too tight, and I'm seeing you coming up and you ain't tied tight either. Are you going to try to bulldoze them? Now, you know, mama's all sweet and holy and everything, and I ain't never done nothing wrong, and you better, do you know what the child might be thinking? Where did this come from? The children, I'm going to tell you where it came from. It came from where you came from. That's where it came from. Don't let it surprise you. It's in all of us. That domino, that house of domino. Let us pray this morning that our houses might not be like that tragedy. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you today for a wonderful, wonderful example of what a non-concerned parent can bring about in the lives of their children. Father, we thank you that for the parent that refuses to communicate, for that parent that's just covering up stuff and playing games, that they might wake up and understand that it doesn't change. It's that way all the time. Father, thank you for speaking to us.